up.
We get a lot of flash flooding around here.
Mom, the street is flooded.
How can we get to our FLL meeting? Can we drive through that water?
Don't worry, Steve. I'll get it to you in time. The engine won't start. You'll have to come and meet me here. Bye.
Need some help?
I need to deliver a package, but now I'm stuck. How can I tell how deep the water is before I reach it?
Let's solve this problem.
Let's start off with the problem identification. We need a clear, very understandable solution to this problem we are studying.
The problem is that cautious drivers in Waukesha County cannot tell the depth of water on flooded streets.
They often drive into unsafe water, which leads to property damage to their vehicle and occasionally even death.
This natural disaster usually occurs in flash floods. It is very dangerous and costly.
Excellent summary. Let's research. Here's a list of 10 quality sources of information we could use.
Well, Dad, that is quite an extensive list.
You even included conducting a survey, working with 12 leading professionals, and more!
We are now ready for an in-depth and extensive problem analysis.
Here comes a police car.
Hello, folks. Looks like you missed the flash flood warning.
Maybe you can help us learn more. So what causes flash floods?
According to Morgan Brooks from NOAA Sullivan Weather Station, flash floods can occur up to 6 hours after rain and are caused by heavy rainfall, water runoff, or other circumstances.
Flash floods happen all around the globe and are hazardous for drivers.
Bill Stolte, the coordinator of the Waukesha County Emergency Operations Center, said emergency vehicles cannot tell the depth of water either. They have to take an alternate route, which slows them down. This is a major problem.
It only takes 6 inches of water to stall a car engine, and 18 inches of water is enough to sweep a car right off the road.
Once a car engine is flooded, it must be replaced. New cars cost between $20,000 and $40,000. That is expensive.
How much do flash floods on streets cause in vehicle damage every year?
After extensive research, we discovered that car damage from floods is not tracked separately from other flooding costs. We then contacted 3 insurance companies who do track this, but they said that information is confidential.
That is too bad. Those stats would have been useful.
Half of all deaths during flash floods are people who died while stuck in their cars.
That is terrible! What is currently being done to help drivers stay safe during flash floods?
Let's do an extensive review on the existing solutions.
There are depth marks on signposts, but they are hard to see and ineffective.
The Lexus car has a sensor that can tell how deep the water is under the car, but that's not good enough because the car has to already be over the water for the sensor to work. By that time, it could be too late.
That is too good. There are no solutions.
There are no solutions that sufficiently solve the problem of drivers not knowing if water on roads is too deep to drive through.
I don't know how I'll be able to make my delivery.
What are you delivering?
I'm delivering a device called Polarized LiDAR to Steve Mitchell, who helped invent it. I don't know much about it. Oh no, Steve just texted and said he's stuck at a flooded street and can't come to pick it up.
We can deliver it.
Thanks.
I'm Steve Mitchell, and this is my partner, Matt Hayman. Thanks for helping us.
What is LiDAR?
LiDAR is like radar, only uses light instead of sound.
How is polarized LiDAR different from regular LiDAR?
Polarized LiDAR uses a polarizing filter to reduce reflections.
In polarization, LiDAR can be used to measure shallow. Currently, we use it to measure glacier melt.
What we need is a team solution to this road flooding problem that is easy, that is clearly explained. No, that is very detailed definition of. No. That's
clearly explained, easy to understand by all.
I've got it. We can put polarized LiDAR in cars and emergency vehicles to measure the depth of flood water and warn drivers with a visual and sound indicator if the water is too deep.
Brilliant. That's a perfect innovative solution.
You've developed a new application of existing ideas that solves the problem in a completely new way.
This original idea would make life so much better and has potential to add significant value for all drivers in Waukesha County.
We should consider factors for implementation. Let's make sure the solution we are proposing is feasible.
Mass production, polarized LiDAR costs us $2,000 to $3,000.
That is way better than replacing a whole car. Let's call it flash drive.
Excellent. Have you shared your project with multiple individuals and groups who can benefit from it?
Yes, we have shared with these 20 groups listed here.
Wow, I've only ever been one of your pigeons.
What's it called again?
Flash drive.
Flash drive, the fantastic flash flood procedure.